How do you manage your code base for your Git repository? Is it right now in GitHub or is it somewhere else? Let's see how we can create the same Git repository which we create in Bitbucket with a private repository setting. If you see in GitHub, you would have created a public repository which everyone can view. In Bitbucket, you can create a private repository, you can create a team and collaborate with the team using Bitbucket. Let's see how we can do that using Bitbucket. Let's get started. Bitbucket is a collaborative tool with which you can use your Git repositories for your teams. So if you are working on an open source project, you would have seen that people use GitHub for putting their open source code. However, Bitbucket has the ability to create private repositories and it is provided by Bitbucket for free. So you can have unlimited projects with private repository settings and you don't have to expose them to anybody else. You can expose it within your teams. So you can create a team and you can add team members to the repository or the project. So you can control them as a private repository using Bitbucket and it is all free. So if you notice, they have lots of softwares in Bitbucket for the Mac and for the Windows. You can create pull requests. You can, whatever you had been doing in GitHub, you can do that in Bitbucket, but it is quite faster. And also Bitbucket provides something called Bitbucket server. Using the Bitbucket server, you can deploy your own Bitbucket instance. So if you deploy your Bitbucket server inside your firm, right? You can get a Bitbucket instance of your own and you can create your own projects from the Bitbucket server. Additional to that, Bitbucket has introduced recently something called Bitbucket pipelines. So Bitbucket pipelines are codes or continuous integration which are run inside the Docker containers. So literally, if you have seen my Jenkins videos, Jenkins is a continuous integration and continuous delivery tool. So Bitbucket has created something called Bitbucket pipelines, which does the same work, but it can do the pipelining concept of the Jenkins as well, and it runs inside a Docker container. So you can even give a Docker image from your code base, which can be used by Bitbucket for running the Docker container. Right. So that is a new thing which Bitbucket has introduced. And if you notice here, Atlassian is the creator of Bitbucket, the guys who created Jira, Bamboo, and Crucible and other stuff, right? So they have created Bitbucket and recently they have changed their logos. That is why if you see these flat logos are slightly different, because Atlassian has now changed their logo a little bit, right? So they own all these Jira and other tools which are like very famous. And if you notice the pricing which I was telling, right? So you don't have to pay anything until for 5 users. You don't have to pay anything. You will have unlimited private repositories. You can create Jiras, you can work on projects, and also the good part is you can create pipelines. So literally you can have a repository which can build for you. So if you have a small team, you can use this as a start, right? So that is what Bitbucket is useful for. The next thing is the standard and premium. You would have seen these. You can just take a look at what are the different offerings from them. So let's see what Bitbucket does. So I have created a Bitbucket project sometime back, but I didn't push anything into Bitbucket project, but this is the Bitbucket project which I have. So bitbucket.org/techprimers. I just created a readme.md just to show you guys. So there is a repository called Jenkins example. This is what I had created. So this is just the settings. You can create new repositories. If you say create, you can either create a repository, basically a project where you can have a code for that particular project. You can create a team, you can create a project. And once you create a project, you can have Jiras created in it, and using those Jiras, you can work on your repositories, right? So let's go inside the repository which I had created called the Jenkins example. If you go inside the repository, you will notice the options are different completely. You have a source option. If you click on the source option, this shows the source code of the particular Jenkins example. Right, and it shows that this is the master branch. So if you see here, you can have n number of branches. Right now I have only the master branch, so I didn't do any other checkout here. And there is only one file which is present in this master branch, which is the readme.markdown file. So this is just the file which is there. So if you click on the source option, you get the source code of each file. If you have multiple files, it shows the files. You click on the file, you can see the content of the file. If it is a markdown file, then you can see it in this particular format, or you can see the source code directly here, right? If you go to commits option so shows the commit with the commit ID, with the message which we committed and the timestamp related to that particular commit. So which is straightforward, and you can see the branches here as well. So right now it is by default having the all branches, so you can see the commits for every branch which is there in this particular repository. If you go to branches, you can see branches. So right now we don't have multiple branches, we have only the master. What I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new branch. I'll just click on the new branch option and just say develop. So this is going to branch out from the master. If you notice here, this is branching from the master. So this will be exactly a copy of the master, right? So I'm just creating a copy of the master just to show you guys some other options as well, right? So the develop got created, right? So it's asking me to check out. I'm not going to check out. Let's go to the branches again, and then let's see if the develop got created. It's not showing, I don't know why. Yeah, right, it's showing that develop is not an active branch. Let's go to develop, right? Okay, it's asking me to check out. Let's click on this option, but I don't know what it is going to do. But yeah, so you can create branches from the branch option. There is something called pull request. So this is where you create a pull request to merge the master. So everyone in the team who works on a story or a Jira, right, they can create a feature branch. So feature branch, in the sense, if you had seen the Git branching strategy, every feature will have a separate feature branch. So if you are working on master, you create a feature branch from the master, and then you have your own feature branch. So your code changes are done only in the feature branch and not in the master. Unlike SVN, in Git you can have multiple branches and then you merge it, right? When you want to merge it, that is when you use the pull request. So pull request is something like you create a pull request from the master. So pull request to the master from the feature branch. So you can create a, so for example, in this case, I can create a pull request from, see, for example, this is develop to master. So I'm going to create a pull request from develop to master. So you can just click the create pull request. It'll by default create the pull request. So if there is a change inside the develop branch, it will show the diff here, right? So I don't know if I can show that. Let me go to the develop branch and then I'll try to create some file. Let me see. Okay, let me go to source. I'll go to develop branch. So what I'll do is I'll just create a new file just to show you let's say new file.md. Right, I'm just going to comment this file. I'm not doing anything else. I just created a file called newfile.md, and I just have YouTube in it. That's it, right? So this file got added. Let's go to the pull request. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a pull request from the develop branch to merge that to the master branch, because we created a new file inside the develop branch, but we need to merge that into master, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the develop branch, which will be the source, and I'm going to merge that into the master. So this is the master here. You can have different branches, but I'm just going to develop merge from the develop to the master branch. And I can give some name to the pull request, merge feature one. I'm just going to say merge feature one, just to be, and you can add some description. You can start adding reviewers here. So this is where you can control your reviewers for your particular code merge, right? And it shows the commits here. If you click on the diff, it shows what has changed. So if you notice here, this is a new file which we changed, so that is why it is showing this as a new file. It is an added file. If there is a diff in the same existing file, it shows as well, right? Once you click on the pull request, a request gets created. So this is similar to the Crucible review request. So whoever is there in the reviewers list, they will get a notification via email. They can go and check the code, and once they are comfortable with the code review process, they can go and approve it. So if you click on the approve button, it'll approve this particular request and the user will be able to merge it. So for example, I approved myself and I'm going to merge it, but in general what you can do is you can control who can approve or how many people can approve and when can you merge, whether there should be a successful build or something like that. So that brings us to the pipeline. But this merge option, if I click on this merge option, this is going to merge my changes from the develop to master. Let's do that, right? So I'm going to click on the merge option, right? So once I click on the merge option, this is going to give my changes to the master as well. So let's go to the master and see if the changes has got reflected. If you notice here in the master, now we have the new file.md, right? And that got merged. So that basically means our pull request got merged. So if I go to the pull request, it should not show up anything. Yeah. And if I move the status to merge, it should show the existing merged one to the master, right? So that is the pull request. So if you are working in with Git, you might already know it. Previously, there was something called stash provided by Atlassian. Now Atlassian has come with something called Bitbucket, which is highly scalable for the cloud. And the next one is the pipelines. This is a completely new concept which Bitbucket has created. So you can run your continuous integration and continuous delivery packages from the Bitbucket pipeline. So which is running on the Docker platform. So all your codes will be running inside the pipeline. So I might not be able to show that today because it needs some changes and stuff. But yeah, just know that Bitbucket pipelines are used for continuous integration, which has similar concept like Jenkins pipeline, but Bitbucket pipelines run on the Docker engine. And you can use Docker images as well, right? So in a different video, I'll show you what is Bitbucket pipeline because that topic itself is a huge one. The other options are just basically download options, what you can download, the whole repository can be backed up, and the boards where you can have the dashboard for your project. Right, there are other settings as well. You can enable web hooks, you can enable hooks from this particular project. Basically, you can enable a REST endpoint call or a SSH call from this particular repository. So if you notice here, there are web hooks for the pipelines. So whenever you modify something to your code base, automatically these web hooks notify the pipeline saying there is a code change. If you have any job, go ahead and run it. So that is what these web hooks does. You can configure anything here. There are other controls as well, like as I mentioned, right? Default reviewers, permissions to the branches, who can merge the request, how many approvers are required for your project and stuff like that. So that is what Bitbucket is. So Bitbucket is a open source free tool for managing your code base inside Git repository. So it is free of cost for now. So you can have 5 members in your team, and then you can have n number of repositories which are private to your team only. You don't have to expose it to everybody like in GitHub, right? And also it provides Bitbucket pipelines which are used for continuous integration and delivery, which uses the Docker runtime, right? So that is what I wanted to cover as a part of this particular video. Hope you guys learned something new and understood what is Bitbucket. If you have any queries, do drop them in the comment section below. If you want me to make videos on any specific topic, do let me know that as well. If you like the video, go ahead and like it. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, go ahead and subscribe to it. Meet you again in the next video. Thank you very much.